The Lord be with you. What I do as a pastor, part four, deeper love and care for one another, my visiting of people. Visiting with people, getting to know them is a high priority for me. Aside from Bible study, which is important for getting to know people, I try to get together with, you know, one or two or three or more people each week, whether it's to chat or to share concerns. Spending time together during the week is vital for a healthy church. Loving one another is another of the lived values that the council has discovered as we've reflected on God's purpose for our church. That is to say, a lived value isn't something you say you value, but when you actually, you know, value by how you live your life. This church genuinely cares for our church family. In a council meeting a few weeks or months ago, we went over every single name in the church. At least one of our members was reaching out to every single person. No one was forgotten. I was impressed. My priority is the hospitalized and homebound as needed. Sometimes this is a lot of time. Sometimes it's almost nothing. Right now, I vary between one homebound visit a month and two or three. This goes up and down. Sometimes the homebound don't let me visit them. I don't know what to say to that. But I try. I'm not very insistent, though. Next importance to me is visiting with our leaders on a regular basis, preferably monthly, though this depends on the leader and on the circumstances. I have a set day each month for some of our leaders, which I really, really appreciate. I'm kind of a creature of habit. If things aren't in my habit, I tend not to do them. Staying in communication and on the same page with our leaders is crucial, very helpful to me and I think the church as well. Partnership with leaders, really important. I'll write more about that next time. Next in importance is spending time with new people and with those who seem less connected and with those with greater needs. And finally, sorry, this is last, but I am trying to visit with all of our members or each of our members once or twice a year. You know, I hope to get to everyone once or twice a year. Though ideally, it would be more often, you know, it, kind of that one-on-one setting. And I don't know how to say this, but some people are really easy to schedule and some people are almost impossible. And that makes scheduling just difficult, especially when I'm waiting on people. You know, I'm trying to schedule someone and then someone doesn't say yes or no, or is hard to schedule. And so that makes it hard to schedule another person if the one person, you know, so this is a character defect that I have, what I'm about to say. So I beg your compassion. But after butting my head up against a wall a few times, I tend to give up, as it tends to suck the life out of me. Yeah, and I feel bad about that. And I keep looking for a better solution. But it is definitely one of the frustrating things about being a pastor is when I meet opposition and I'm thinking, this should be easier. Should be. Yes, should. Not a good word. Of course, I hope this would be obvious, what I'm about to say, but our church family visiting each other is far more valuable than me visiting anybody. And by the way, I did say that my visits are important. Here, I am emphasizing how much more important our mutual care for one another is, and especially for the most vulnerable among us. It multiplies the benefits the more we're actually all participating and loving one another. But sadly, this is the area that I most feel like a failure. Scheduling conflicts, urgent matters, and just life in general make visiting as much as I would like much more difficult than it should be. And of course, I easily fall into doldrums and bad attitudes, which makes it harder to do what I'm supposed to do. So I am grateful to God that I do this much better than when I was younger, you know, 25 years ago or even 5 years ago for that matter. And I'm also grateful beyond belief to my wife for joining me as often as she can. And I think you all know this, but, you know, you're getting kind of a two for one with me and my wife. She is such a blessing. And I think you all know that. Next time in the next video, we'll look at my partnership with the leaders in the church. God bless.